In this video session, I am going to discuss the solution to the decision-making algorithm where we are asked to find or develop the logic to find the largest of four unequal numbers. We have already done something similar to this. We found the smallest of three numbers. This is a little opposite to that, but the thinking other than the basic logic is almost similar. So here what I have is, I need four memory locations called as A, B, C, D to store the four numbers. Large is going to contain the largest of those four numbers. Then in the second step, what I'm doing is I'm going to ask the user, enter the value of A, B, C and D. That means enter values into four memory locations. Then what I'm assuming is, I have not seen the other numbers. So I'm just going to process one number at a time. Since I'm processing one number at a time, I'm going to initially assume that A itself is the largest. Then in step number four, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to compare B with large. If B is bigger than large, then what is going to happen is, I'm going to replace the value of large with B. Okay, suppose this was 1 and this was 2. So now large would be 2. In step number 5, I'm just going to do something similar. I am going to compare C with large. So if C is greater than large, then I'm going to say large is C. Alright. Now, there's only one variable left. Quite easy. So I'm going to just check if D is greater than large. If D is greater than large, then what I'm going to say is, I'm going to say large is D. And finally, at the seventh step, I'm simply going to go ahead and print that the largest is large, and then I'm going to stop. The best way to understand any logic is, try to take out a test table and do the testing. So what I'll do here is, I'll put up a sample of values, we'll run through the test and let us see what results we get. So in step number one, I have not given initial values to any of them. So all of them are question mark, because the computer is going to assign random values to these particular chaps. Step number two, let us say I give A as minus 1, B as 0, C as 3 and D as 1. Large has not changed because nothing of large is touched in step number 2. In step number 3, large should automatically be minus 1 because I am going to deal with one number at a time. So in step number 3, you will see large has become minus 1. Then in step number 4, I am checking if 0 is greater than minus 1. Definitely 0 is bigger than minus 1. So my new large will become 0 as per this step. Then I come to step number 5. In step number 5, what I am trying to do here is, I am again comparing C, okay, which is 3, with 0. Definitely 3 is bigger than 0, so 3 becomes my new large. In step number 6, I am comparing D with large. Is 1 bigger than 3? That is false. So large remains still as 3. And in the last step, I am going to print 3. To get a better understanding of this, take different combination of these values, run through the logic, and I'm sure you will get a deeper understanding. So even if it is for 4, 5, 6, 7 numbers, you just have to increase the number of if statements. Just think a little bit why you cannot use the if, else if, else if here. Try using, instead of if, just try remove all these 5, 6, 7, use if, else if or else here, and create this table and run through. Just see what will happen for different combinations of data. That will help you understand logic at a much deeper and more conceptual level.